Okay, let's do wind load calculation as per IS 875 1987 part 3 with an example. Here I am taking a plan of an RC building. The building plan having 4 bays in longitudinal direction and 3 bays in lateral direction. Let us take dimension for this bays. I am taking 6 meter of each bay for longitudinal direction and 5 meter for each bay in lateral direction. Okay, so the total dimension is 24 meter for longitudinal and 15 meter for lateral direction. Now, so for this RC building, the given data is something like this. I'm taking number of stories is 10. Particular height of story is 3 meter, so it will be the total height of structure is 30 meter. I'm taking location of structure in city of Vadodara. Design life of structure is assumed 50 years, taking category in number 3 and taking topography is plain with upwind slope less than 3 degree. So I can say that the angle is here less than 3 degree. I already taken some size of structural elements, which are beam size 300 by 600 mm. The column size I'm taking 450 by 450 mm and the slab thickness is 150 mm. Now let's take two calculations. Step number one, the design wind speed, which is denoted as VZ. As per the mathematical expression, VZ is VB, K1, K2, K3. You can see here what is VB, K1, K2 and K3. We know that VB is our basic wind speed, which is in meter per second. K1 is a probability factor. We can also say that it is a risk coefficient. K2 is in terrain, height, structure, size factor. K3 is topography factor. Basically, K1, K2 and K3 are the multiplication factor depending upon their relations. VB is basic wind speed. What is basic wind speed? So as we know that as per Indian standard 875 part 3, the map of India is divided in parts and give the basic wind speed for some important cities. Let me show you. Here is code Indian standard 875, which is given in Appendix A. You can see that the basic wind speed at 10 meter height for some important cities or towns. Okay, so as you know that for this example, I am taking city Vadodara. First of all, we have to find the basic wind speed of Vadodara from this table. You can see here, I am finding the city of Vadodara, which is having 44 meter per second basic wind speed. So let us calculate. VB is 44 meter per second. I am writing in bracket for city Vadodara, taking from appendix A, IS 875 1987 part 3. Now second, we have to find probability factor, that is also known as the risk factor, which is a factor K1. Okay, what is K1? K1 depends on the life of a structure, and you can find this from table number 1, of the Indian standard 875 that I am showing you. Table number 1. For all general building structure, as I already assumed, the design life of the structure is 50 years, and as my basic wind speed is 44 meter per second, so here my K1 factor is nothing but 1. So let's write K1. I am taking 1 from where it is IS 875 1987, part 3, table number 1, which depends on basic wind speed of the structure and the design life of the structure. Now let us take factor K3. We will find K2 after finding K3. What is K3? We know that now factor K3, which is a topography factor, and it is based on a topography upwind slope. So as per our data, we have already taken, you can see here, as per our given data, we have taken topography plane with upwind slope less than 3 degrees. So when upwind slope is less than 3 degrees, we have to take K3 factor is 1. So let's take K3 factor is 1. You can find it, it is in clause number 5.3.3.1 for IS 875 1987 part 3, for topography with upwind speed slope angle less than 3 degrees. Now factor K2, which is a terrain height and structure size factor, which depends on the terrain categories and the size of the structure. You can find K2 factor from IS 875 table number 2. I'm showing you table number 2 of 875. You can see here the name of a table number 2 is K2 factor to be obtained, design and speed variation with the height in different terrain for the different classes of the building or a structure. You can see the structure is the variation of the height, okay, in ascending order. It also classified in terrain categories 1, 2, 3 and 4, with also subclassified with class A, B and C for the different categories. Or we can say for the different terrain categories. And our building data, we already taken the category number 3. Now we have to determine class. What is class and how can you find that? Let me first write for factor K2. It is terrain category. Now we have to determine class, whether it is A, B or C. How can you find that? We know that class is based on the maximum dimension of the structure. So let I am taking both elevation and plan. This is a plan of our building and this is the elevation of our building. So what are the dimension? As we know that if I am taking this height of the structure, as this is elevation, height of the structure which is 30 meter. If this is width of the structure which is 15 meter. And if I am showing you this one is plan which is 24 meter length, longitudinal direction, and for the lateral direction width is 15 meter. So we can say that the maximum dimension for this building is 30 meter. So the maximum dimension of the building is 30 meter. Then this structure should be fall in class number B, as you can see here. Class number B, which suggests if the maximum dimension whether in a greatest horizontal or in a vertical dimension between 20 to 50 meter. And here our building is fall in category class B. So I'm just taking class B. As I told you that factor K2 is varies with the height of the structure. So we have to prepare a table as per the height of the structure. So let us prepare a table as per the height and factor K2. Now let's see, in table number 2 we have terrain category 3 and class number B. So we have to see this column. If my story height is 10 meter, then you can see the value of K2 is 0.88. So let's write here, if the height is up to 10 meter, K2 is 0.88. If up to the height between 10 to 15, K2 is 0.94. To the height 15, K2 is 0.94. Now for the 20 meter height, it is 0.98. For the 20, K2 is 0.98. Next is 30. Our total height of the structure is 30 meter. So it is our final value for the K2, which is 1.03. Let's say if our height maybe 32 meter, then we have to interpolation between 30 to 50, but here our height is only 30 meter, so our final value of the table K2 is 1.03. and so how we already determine our K1, K2 and K3 factor. Now we have all values for our step number 1, which is design wind speed, VZ, VB, K1, K2 and K3. Okay, now let's prepare a table to determine design wind speed with the variation of a height of the building. We have value of VB, K1, K2 and K3. We have to prepare this table as we know that the value of K2 is varying between the heights 10, 15, 20 and 30. VB is a basic wind speed, which is a constant for as per the city. We have already determined value K1, which is 1, and for K3 also we have find value 1, as the theta is less than 3 meter, and we have already determined the value of K2 as per our variation of building height. So for 10 meter is 0.88, for 15 it is 0.94, it is 20 for 0.98, and for 30 it is 1.03, and finally we have to determine VZ, the design wind speed. Let us calculate. When we multiply all these four factors, VB, K1, K2 and K3, the value is something 38.72 meter per second. For 15 height it is something 41.36. This VZ is unit is meter per second. Now for step number 2, it is design wind pressure, denoted as PZ, as per the clause number 5.4 IS 875 part 3. We can see that PZ is related with VZ, and so it shows the relationship between wind pressure and wind velocity So the unit is Newton per meter square. Now let us calculate PZ with respect to VZ. We already calculated VZ with a table with a variation of a height. So now let's calculate PZ for height number 10 meter. VZ we have find 38.72. So the PZ it should be multiply with 0.6 and square of a VZ it is something 899.54 Newton per meter square. And similarly, we should determine for 15 meter height. And you can see here the table for PZ for each height 10, 15, 20 and 30 in unit Newton per meter square. Now for step number 3, the design wind load, it is denoted as F. The formula for design wind load is F is equal to CF A multiplied by PZ. We can see here CF is a force coefficient of a building, A is effective frontal area, and PZ is nothing but the design wind load, whichever is already determined. Now, to determine force coefficient of a building, let us go on page number 39 of IS 875. Here you can see two graphs, figure number 4A and figure number 4B, which is, you can see both graph are for to determine the value of CF. Okay, you can see here the value of CF is on y-axis and value of A by B which are on x-axis, and the curve represent between them which are the value of H by B. Okay, now when H by B value is more than 1, then we have to use graph number 4A, and if the H by B value is less than 1, we have to use this graph number 4B. Now let us determine these three parameters A, B and H. Okay, you can see here this plan and elevation of the building which shows which dimension can be A, B and H if the direction of wind is from this direction. Now let we assume the direction of wind is from this side of the building. So our three parameters can be, let me draw plan and elevation type of building. If the wind load is from this direction, then as per the figure, this portion will be B. So it will be 24 meter. This portion will be A, which is 15 meter. And let's take out the elevation. Here the wind force is from this direction. The total height of the structure is 30 meter, and here is A which is 15 meter. Okay, so I think we have A is equal to 15 meter, B is equal to 24 meter and H is equal to 30 meter. So let's determine A by B, which is 15 by 24, 0.625 something, and H by B is equal to 30 by 24, which is 1.25. Now let's determine the value of CF from figure 4A or 4B. Now we already know that if H by B value is more than equal to 1, we have to see figure number 4A. Now Okay. Let us go with x axis. On a by b, we have value a by b is 0.625. It is somewhere here between 0.5 to 1. It is somewhere here 0.625. Then let us find the curve h by b, which is 1.25. You can see here this first curve value having 1 and the second curve value having 3. So our 1.25 value should be somewhere between 1 and 3, somewhere here. So let if I coincide these 2 points and extend up to the y-axis, and we can determine our CF factor. I think it is somewhere 1.2. Now for A, which is effective frontal area of the building, means the area of a building which come in contact, or we can say which directly come in contact with the wind. So if we assume wind is from this direction, and if we want to calculate wind per meter height of the structure, so area will be 6 multiplied by 1 meter square. 6 is a distance of particular bay which is come in direct contact with a wind. Okay, so now let's find value of F. Here I already written the value of CF for the step number 3, which is 1.2. value of A is 6 meter square, and we have PZ we determined in step number 2. So let's prepare a table as per the height variation. Prepare a table with respect to height. PZ is already determined. CF, which is a multiplication of CF, A and PZ in Newton per meter. Now for 0 to 10 meter height, we already discussed the PZ value is 899.54. For 10 to 15 meter height, 1026.38 PZ. For 15 to 20 meter height, it is 111.560, and for the last 20 to 30 meter, it is 1232.34. Now the value of F are value of F is converted in kilonewton per meter. With the values of design wind loads, we have to draw force diagram for varying height of the structure. Okay, you can see here I already draw the height variation of the building from 0 meter to 30 meter. Now here we know that up to 0 to 10 our force value is 6.58 kilonewton per meter. For 10 to 15 it is 7.5, and so on. So let's draw this. For 0 to 10 It is 6.58. Force is constant up to 0 to 10. And the value is 6.58 kilonewton per meter. Now, for the next meters, 10 to 15 meters, it is 7.513. Of course, it is more than 6.58. So we should make a line like this. And okay, the force between 10 to 15 meter, it changes the variation of the load 7.513 kilonewton per meter. Now so on, and you can see the complete pressure diagram for 0 to 30 meters. This force diagram is changed with the height. So here we find wind force per meter height, but generally we required load intensity at a different story in kilonewton. So let us calculate the wind force at each story in kilonewton. For that, again, we have to prepare a table for each story and the story height. You can see I have already prepared a table for the calculation of wind force at each story level in kilonewton. Let us start to fill this table. First of all, we have to write the column number 1, story number, and start from the descending order. Let's start for the story number 10. The loading level is 27 to 30. As we know that height of each story is 3 meter, which is 3 meter. Okay. And our design force is something 9.02 kilonewton per meter for the height between 20 to 30. So here we should write 9.020. You can see here it is 9.02. Similarly, let us calculate with story number 9. Level of the loading should be 24 to 27, again 3 meter. It is something 8.76. Now you will think, how will you determine 8.76? It is because at 20 meter height, the pressure is something 8.166, and at 30 meter height, the pressure is something 9.02. So if we want to calculate at level of 27, which is acting somewhere here, so the pressure variation will be increased. It is definitely more than 8.16 and definitely less than 9.02. So we have to interpolate this value and determine, and with interpolation you will get the value 8.76. Similarly, for story number 8, the level is something 21 to 24, story height is 3 meter, and the design force is something 8.50. similarly, I did interpolation. And you can see I have written for the story number 10 to story number 1 with each story level, and the height of the story is 3 meter and the design 4. We definitely know that from story number 1 to story number 3, the design force will be constant, as you can see here, design force is constant for the 0 to 10 meter height. Okay, and other height we have to do interpolation, and to fill this last column, which is wind force at each story level, which is nothing but 0.020, which is design force multiplied by the height of each story. So if we calculate 9.020 multiplied by 3, the value will be something 27.06 kilonewton, and so on. We have to calculate for all stories, and here you can see the wind force at each story level. Now we have to draw this with a diagram. Here I have already shown different story level from 0 to 10. So let's mark the force. For story number 0 to 1, it is 19.74, which is from here. For story number 2, it is again 19.74. For story number 3, it is again 19.74. For story number 4, it is 21.39. For 5, 22.53. For story number 3, it is 23.7. For story number 7, it is 24.75. For story number 8, 25.5. For 9, 26.28. And the last one, story number 10, it is 27.06. So you can see this complete wind force distribution for the each story level and with the variation of a height, and for each nodal story, wind force in kilonewton. Thank you.